Funding provided by Musco Lighting, the sports lighting specialist, providing lighting systems for you, your project, and your community.
The Pella Rolscreen Foundation is a proud supporter of Iowa PBS. Pella Windows and Doors strives to better our communities and build a better tomorrow.
And by Fareway Meat and Grocery. For more than 80 years, Fareway has been proud to be an active part of the communities we serve. Learn more at fareway.com.
With our Iowa roots and Midwestern values, Farmers Mutual Hale is committed to offering innovative farm insurance for America's farmers, just as we have for six generations. Farmers Mutual Hale, America's crop insurance company.
Place for Championship Thursday. There's a look at the trophy. They even got Herky the Hawk decked out in pink, celebrating the Iowa girl. Live look inside as it's number one versus number two. It's not always you play for a championship one versus two. You're going to see that here. Dike-New Hartford undefeated 49-0. Hinton pretty darn close to undefeated. They only have suffered one loss all year. Eric Braley back west for this one, and Dike-New Hartford, they look really good.
Really good. They've played 29 matches against state qualifying teams, and they've won them all. They're undefeated, so bringing in a really good resume, but don't count out Hinton.
Yeah, last year at this time, Dike-New Hartford, they were on paper the team to beat, and they did not win the championship. So here's a look at Hinton. Second straight trip to state, and they wanted to improve on what happened last year. Sophomore Bailey Booby averages a class 2A best 2.5 blocks per set. Really good front row player, leads the team in also kills per set. And then also just multiple players able to step up and help out this team. Gavarna, the senior setter, you see the numbers on your screen right there. She's a 6-foot setter, which could potentially pose some problems for Dike-New Hartford's defense, but a well-rounded Hinton team.
A solid blocker in the front row at 6 feet, you're right, but Booby as a sophomore carrying this team through the quarters and semis, and she's hoping to do that tonight in the championship.
31-0, undefeated, beat a lot of good teams, not just at the 2A level, and senior Peyton Peterson, she's arguably the best player in the state at volleyball and basketball. We'll get a chance to showcase her throughout the broadcast. But we want to send it to Rex Baker, who is the public address announcer with the Golden Plaque Awards.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union's Golden Plaque of Distinction Award is given annually to an Iowa coach who has demonstrated a successful career while making notable contributions towards school, community, and the coaching profession. Presenting this year's Golden Plaque Award is IGHSAU Executive Director Gene Berger and Volleyball Administrator Ben Van Wyk. The recipient of this year's Golden Plaque Award in volleyball is Jim Beamer from Lake Mills. Jim coached volleyball from 1992 through 2022, all at Lake Mills. He led his Bulldogs to 22 conference titles while collecting 950 career wins. He guided four teams to the state tournament, earning Class 2A runner-up honors in 2010. Jim also coached Lake Mills to the school's only state softball tournament appearance and also coached wrestling. He served as the school's athletic director for 17 years. Jim has been active as a member of the IGHSAU Volleyball Advisory Committee, is a past president of the Iowa High School Athletic Directors Association, and just finished an 8-year term as a member of the IGHSAU Board of Directors as the athletic director at large. Coach Beamer has also been active in the Iowa Girls Coaches Association. Jim and his wife Angie are the parents of three sons, Lincoln, Grant, and Kale, daughter-in-law Cara, and proud grandparents to grandson Canyon. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to this year's recipient of the IGHSAU Golden Plaque of Distinction in volleyball, Jim Beamer from Lake Mills.
it's not just for one or two seasons. It's decades of work and dedication for that. And that's the whole part about today with it being the championships. It's not just giving out the team awards. It's some individual recognition, a Hall of Fame. And they do it right here in making it a recognition for many individuals.
Exactly. Celebrating the past, but also putting on the forefront the fantastic Iowa girls who are here in the present. So really cool to honor both the past and the present. And the Iowa Girls Union, they do it in a special way.
They turned the lights out on us, and you see the smoke coming from the corner. You're going to see some flames being shot out pretty soon, too, as we are about to meet the individuals and teams playing for this Class 2A title. Here's how they got here. Dike-New Hartford defeated Eddyville, Blakesburg, Fremont, and then Denver in the semifinals, each in three straight sets. Hinton took down Applington, Parkersburg, and Grundy Center to get to the championship match for the Class 2A tournament pairings. Other teams representing who made state, see Kemper Catholic as well. Here's a look at the player lounge. This is new this year here in Coralville. It's an off-court spot. I hung out there for a little bit with you yesterday just to check it out. Athletes get to chill out, keep an eye on current matches, and unwind between games, like maybe challenge a friend to a tabletop cornhole, do some dancing and fun, claim a seat on the throne as queen of the court. Awesome experience here. Let's now welcome the teams to the court where they're gonna face off for the 2A championship match.
Fans, it's time to meet our teams. First, please welcome to the floor the Hinton Blackhawks. Please welcome the Dike-New Hartford Wolverines.
Dike-New Hartford, 33rd state tournament trip. Only to Western Christian, who just won the 3A championship.
First, for the Hinton Blackhawks, number 2, Sailor Yower. Number 3, Hannah Paulson. Number 4, Ava Vondrak. Number 6, Natalie Nelson. Number 8, Andy Joe Walker. Number 11, Olivia Peterson. Number 13, Caitlin Hopling. Number 15, Eva Van Acker. Your assistant coach for the Black Sox, Nolan Hazy. Now, let's meet the starters for Hinton. A 5'8" senior, number 5, Gabby Friesen. A 5'9" senior, number 7, Carlene Hicklin. A 5'11" sophomore, number 9, Bailey Boovie. A 5'9" sophomore, number 10, Carlin Kovarna. A 6-foot senior, number 12, Ashlyn Kovarna. A 5'10" senior, number 14, Avery Burgad. And the libero for the Blackhawks, a 5'2" senior, number 17, Belle DeRocher. Co-head coaches for the Blackhawks are Robin Moore and Kate Ortegren.
Now let's meet the Dike-New Hartford Wolverines. Number 3, Addie Joslin. Number 4, Claire McCumber. Number 6, Maddie Musco. Number 7, Indy Grassley. Number 9, Kaylin Meester. Number 11, Izzy Norton. Number 13, Mallory Peterson. Number 14, Peyton Nolan. The assistant coaches for Dike-New Hartford, Lawrence Harms, Abby Perez, and Emma Eden. Now let's get the starters for Dike-New Hartford. A 5'5" junior, number 1, Lucy Varney. A 6-foot senior, number 2, Marin Bixby. A 5'6" senior, number 5, Shelby Ort. A 5'8" senior, number 8, Jaden Peterson. A 5'9" junior, number 12, Shannon Mormon. A 5'11" senior, number 21, Peyton Peterson. And the libero for the Wolverines, a 5'5" sophomore, number 10, Abby Jensen. Head coach for the Wolverines is Diane Harms. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to meet the officials for today's match. Our first referee, Jennifer Lewis. Our second referee, Nikki O'Keefe. And our line judges, Ashley Pierce and Haley Gedkin. Ladies and gentlemen, the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union promotes good sportsmanship by participants, coaches.
To a championship match, there's a look at the winner's circle and celebrating there after winning a championship. Lots of photo ops to pose with the trophy. That is just beyond where the volleyball match is going to be played. A lot of square footage here where you can have a winner's circle as well as a two-way matchup.
A fantastic facility. It is a great new home for the championships, and you're right, there's plenty of space for the court, great view from any seat in the house, and still space for a winner's circle.
And the pink throne, who will get to celebrate in the winner's circle there? Let's take a look at the keys to the match. And Beth, what do you think it's gonna come down for Hinton in order to give Dike-New Hartford their first loss of the year?
We're looking for the Blackhawks to start aggressively against this tough DNH team to try to set the tone early. Hinton wants to communicate well, serve strong, and battle as a team. They've accomplished so much this year, and now it's time to play with energy and leave it on the court.
Two great keys for Hinton. What's it gonna take for Dike-New Hartford?
On paper, you talked about it, DNH is the favorite with lots of talented and experienced team members. But to beat an energized Hinton squad, the Wolverines want to continue their scrappy defense. They can frustrate opponents like crazy with their never let the ball drop defensive mentality. And secondly, DNH is just looking to continue their undefeated momentum to bring home another state crown.
Bobby Peterson, your head coach, back when you played for the Oni Panthers. She has two daughters leading the way for Dike-New Hartford. Sydney Peterson next to her as well, who was libero of the year in the Missouri Valley Conference and helped Texas make the national championship game. A lot of people in attendance for the two-way matchup. Hinton, Dike-New Hartford, are you ready for some volleyball? 5A champions, Waukee Northwest. 4A went to North Scott. 3A Western Christian. Who's it gonna be here in 2A? And mind you, programming note, we still have the 1A matchup. Beth and I will be here. Scheduled to start at 7 o'clock. It'll be Ankeny Christian versus Holy Trinity Catholic. That's a long ways away, as we expect this one to be a good one. Dike-New Hartford number 1, Hinton number 2. The two have combined for one loss on the entire year.
Serving first will be Hinton in the blue and black. It's Dike-New Hartford. They're celebrating the first point of the match.
With an in-system quality pass there on serve receive. DNH running their middle. Bixby right away. She has a high contact point off those hands. First point goes to the Wolverines.
Bixby had 328 kills, third best on the team, a 450 kill efficiency. Love the fight out of Hinton there and not let DNH put a run together as they get the equalizer. Aces across the board, 1-1 in the first.
We talked in pregame about Boobie, number 9 in the front row. She starts with a kill for Hinton. She goes high cross court, smart shot for a sophomore. She's going to be key to Hinton doing well today.
Two straight points, and it's Bailey Boobie, 340 kills on the season, a 4.64. It's like a batting average in baseball or softball, a 4.64 kill efficiency for Boobie. Hard to believe she has two more years left. Block back to Dyke's side. They're going to call a lift by the Wolverines. Three straight points for the Blackhawks.
Good size to the Hinton double block right there. Number 12 listed at 6 feet. Boobie listed at 5'11". Putting up four solid arms to seal the block on that point.
Hinton denied the first time. Now Dike-New Hartford with the slide, and it's down for a point. Why is that such a tough play to defend, Matt?
Slide behind the setter, so your block is chasing it to the pin there, and you see Hinton's back row defense kind of getting sucked in, just kind of following that flow rather than holding her position on that sideline, and that's where Bixby went. She went that cross-court sideline, a really great shot on that slide.
Hit off the hands of the block. Another point for Hinton. Playing with all the confidence in the world right now.
Absolutely. You know, playing with nothing to lose. Why not us? DNH is undefeated. Why can't Hinton be the ones to give them their first loss?
Good pass. Here's the set flying in. Peterson. That's Peyton Peterson, who led the team with 560 kills in the regular season.
That's a whole lot of kills, and we saw why on that swing. She jumps well. We're going to see her have really good vision as well as blocking, staying home, taking care of that overpass, and, of course, staying clean on her side of the net, just putting up a wall.
4-4, early stages of the first set. You're watching the Class 2A championship match from Extreme Arena in Coralville, Iowa. Beth West, Eric Braley on the call. And now a little surge happening for the blue and black Wolverines out of Dike-New Hartford, really answering the call after the early run by Hinton.
Hinton putting up a double block, but Peyton able to swing around it again, going high to her advantage to work around the block. And on the flip side, we see the same thing with Boobie, swinging out of the middle, working around that block, cutting back. This is going to be a fun one.
Very early indication is it is going to be a knockdown, drag-out battle to the end. Service air, little too much as Boobie on the season has a number of aces. How about 50 of them during the season to lead the team in that category? She's being very aggressive, and that's what talking with the coaches, co-head coaches for Hinton, they said, our whole plan is to serve aggressively. If we want to win the title, that's what we need to do.
Serve aggressive because you want to get your opponent, you want to get DNH out of system, you want to get them out of sorts. If DNH can pass well and stay in system, they have so many high power offensive weapons, and so Hinton knows, hey, we can't give them free balls, we can't give them easy serves, we got to be aggressive.
What a shot. Defense sucked into the middle, close to the net, the golden corner wide open. Look how she just tips it to that corner for the point.
Making a good swing out of a miscue, a little miscommunication there, running that set in a different spot than she was expecting. DNH able to respond, though, with a back row attack. Good swing there.
Point as Peyton Peterson serving, five-time All-State Tournament captain in volleyball and basketball, where they won several state titles as well. Placement right on the money. Kovarna, that's Carlin Kovarna, the underclassman, with the play.
Good vision, painting that sideline so close, but again, disguising it till the very end, which is important when you're tipping. Make the blockers think you're gonna swing, and then at the last minute, change it up and tip short.
9-7. Checking out of the lineup for Dike-New Hartford is Shannon Mormon, the junior. Off the hands of the block. Wolverines have it. Through the block, punched up. And now in system is Dike-New Hartford. Big swing, look out! Look out below as that came in red hot.
Good adjustment from DNH. That tip brought Jaden into the middle rather than trying to transition all the way to the outside. She just said, hey, set me two ball right in the middle, and she swings away. I like the adjustment.
First to double digits here in this first set is your number one undefeated Dike-New Hartford. Playing real good volleyball, though, is Hinton. But they find themselves trailing by four. You get two timeouts. Neither team has used one yet. Here's the serve. Struggling, and now knocking it over to the Wolverine side. Down ball. To the outside, down the line, it goes out of bounds, no touch. And you might see a timeout soon. There it is. Good serving from Abby Jensen for Dike-New Hartford. A couple of mistakes by Hinton. Now they find themselves trailing by five. Let's go inside their huddle.
We're going up on our block, all right? We have to find their arm. We have to get on their arm. Right now we're on the side of them, okay? And we cannot let a single block happen in the middle, all right? So talk that out. If she's more in the three zone, right side, you need to come over and help block that because she's turning it this way. She's running a slider of one, left side, you come block that, okay? Get on their arm, time it out, all right? We're just a little early, we're a little jittery, okay? Defense, move, get back to base quickly and talk to each other. Come on, you got it. You got it, let's go.
Family on three, one, two, three, family.
You got it, one pass, one pass.
Co-head coaches Robin Moore and Kate Ortegern trying to exude confidence and great advice and instruction.
Reminding her team to communicate, 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 and also help on the block. Got to get double blocks up to try to slow down the powerful attacks that are going to be coming from DNH.
Struggling, receiving the serve. Free ball to the Wolverines. Quick set, middle, hammer time again. Dike-New Hartford starting to get in that zone where they're just starting to take over.
Their offense mixes up the set locations of their hitters. So again, on that one, Jaden normally on the outside, but bringing her into the middle because she is just a jack of all trades, can really be crafty and creative in her shot selection and utilizing that to the fullest. Hinton, though, with a good response to get that side out. Good back row attack there.
Super sophomore, had 13 kills, 39 assists in the semifinals. This team always has shown so much grit, perseverance, and drive for Hinton this season. Only one loss on the year, conference champions. They won every tournament they were in. Whole bunch of winners on their side of the net. Wolverines with some options here. to go with the tip, and it's gonna work for a point. Not how you draw it up, but it works.
A little bit of a miscommunication, but Jaden bettering that ball, knowing where she was on the court, seeing the defense to be able to still tip it over to a really good spot, even though that wasn't, like you said, the play that they were intending to run.
Claire McCumber, Addie Jocelyn check into the lineup. McCumber serving, leading by a 14-8 score is Dike-New Hartford. They had to send it over. They did just that. Blocked down for a point. That hit, that swing was coming in, but the block was nearly perfect.
The pass and the set were really tight to the net, so it was kind of a trap situation there because the DNH block was pressed over so well. Not a lot of space to work with when you're that tight on the net, wanting to keep the sets off the net so you can work around the block.
Mercy, what a play.
Big swing from Bixby, taking care of that overpass. That's mine.
Wasted no time at all. Again, there's not just one or two offensive weapons on this DNH team. There's back row players, there's setters, there's middles, there's outside hitters, all across the board, fundamentally sound. And second and final timeout called here by Hinton.
Really good servers too, you forgot that.
Yeah, very true.
Just saw a wonderful ace serve.
Let's go inside the DNH huddle with Coach Harms.
Talk loud so that our centers know where you're going. I'm fine, switch up our what we're doing for free balls and all that stuff, but we gotta talk so our centers know where we're putting the ball, okay? So make sure we're communicating, keep scrambling. If you can get the ball, call it, step in, we'll go out of system. We practice that a lot, right? So don't hesitate. If you can get to the ball, call it, step in, give us a chance to take a swing, all right? Here we go.
Good job, lady.
Coach Harms, Diane Harms, 30 years of coaching, 21 coming at DNH, 1,072 career victories, 807 at Dike-New Hartford, 18 state tournament appearances. She knows how to run a program, 49-0.
That is quite the resume. I think you could keep going. There's some more.
So many. I don't think I got the state championships and all of that. Well, Dike-New Hartford is good at many sports. Girls basketball championship. They won it in 2021, 2022, and 2023. Would assume they are the favorites to defend their title again this year. An attack air. And now a double-digit lead for Dike-New Hartford. More strong serving from Claire McCumber, one of those senior leaders. Off the hands, down to the point. They needed that, and now they need to put a run together.
Needed it, and Booby delivered high off the hands, listed as a middle blocker, but she's one of those players that we see swing from multiple locations. In serve receive there, running her on the outside. I like that, giving a different look. She can swing from anywhere.
Mix it up, get her the ball. Yower serving. Off the hands, down that line for a point. Checking into the lineup, this is Carlin Kovarna, the sophomore who played in 79 sets, had 115 kills, a 245 kill efficiency, and averages 1.5 kills per set. Oh, and over the block, the return, free ball to Dike-New Hartford. Gonna try this again. No returning that one, 20-9.
Libero for Hinton in the right spot. Peyton bringing a lot of heat. On that second one, though, you see her making the Hinton player dive for it. I apologize, I said the libero. Different position on that outside defense. Great swing, though, from Peyton. Getting the second shot and putting it away.
What a nice-looking play there from the pass and the set, and Booby knocks it through. She knows she has to carry this team, and Beth, they might not be able to come back and win this first set, but at least having a goal of getting 15, 16, 17 points takes momentum in that second set would be big for their confidence.
Building momentum to take into future sets and also figuring out, hey, what works, what places are open, what can we do potentially in the next set right from the beginning to have maybe a different outcome. But right now, a pretty large margin for DNH.
The slide was there, just a little long on the attack, and now Dike-New Hartford 3 points away. Dike-New Hartford has won 107 of 108 total sets this season. One of the most dominant teams in Iowa high school state volleyball history. They only went four, meaning they swept everyone except for 5A West Des Moines Dowling.
Incredible.
Yeah.
And Dowling was in the 5A championship this morning.
A very...
just incredible.
Battle-tested team. And that's why they exude confidence right now when the lights are shining as bright as they are. Peterson again. Her parents, we talked about her mom being the head volleyball coach, Bobby Peterson. She's the winningest coach in UNI volleyball history and the Missouri Valley Conference history. Looks like they have another undefeated team and NCAA team, but her father also is a standout football player as well, so fun to watch that connection. Now it's 23-12. Let's go to our net camera. We got cameras all over this extreme arena, and you can see the block was there, but the attack was that much better.
Exactly, attack into the hands of the block and then off the antenna.
And then Hinton slams the door on the attack by DNH. A little bit of momentum shift here. Still trailing by 10. And here's that block again.
Pressing into the court, you see there, lining up and then pressing in to keep that block inbound.
Three in a row. And Hinton really likes this rotation right now. They're getting great serves. Dike-New Hartford still has two timeouts, but with this lead, I think Coach Harms is gonna try and let them figure it out on their own. In the net violation is the call by the down official, and that will bring up set point as Peterson to serve. That's number 21, Peyton Peterson. Hinton looking for the point. Overpass. And the point to DNH. A lift call. She kind of palmed it and threw it down. And that's how this first set comes to a close. Dike-New Hartford kind of started slow. Picked up some steam, and they win it 25-14. We'll break it all down. We'll look at some highlights and stats and bring you the second set right after this from Extreme Arena in Coralville. You're tuned in to the Iowa High School Volleyball Championships here on Iowa PBS.
You're watching live coverage of the Girls State Volleyball Championships on Iowa PBS. Stay tuned. More to come.
Native people are still here. We're not a stereotype. We're doing things to make a difference in this world.
Nobody's good at war. I have no choice but to fight for my country.
Could not imagine existence without the buffalo.
It's really great to work with oysters.
Here you go.
Whoa.
Your men need you.
Seems pretty conclusive.
I could make it worth your while.
He's got himself embroiled with a gangster.
Are you trying to get me killed?
I can't get back to how it was before.
We need you.
We hold the line at all costs.
This is the fight now.
You don't have to turn everything into an investigation.
There's always someone watching.
Sunday evening at 7 on Iowa PBS.
From relationships between superpowers.
Hungry people are dangerous people.
To individuals just passing along an idea.
We were representing Iowa.
Iowans have been there to extend a hand in friendship or lift up people in need.
Dad just saw people hurting and he wanted to help.
These citizen diplomats took hold of a moment in time and built long-lasting relationships.
I would say I have moved the needle.
Monday at 8 p.m.
Dike-New Hartford wins set one, 25-14 over Hinton. Feels like Hinton has to really figure some things out here in order to flip the script as we take a look at some highlights. And really, Gooby, I mean, 9 kills in one set is really, really good.
That is a large number for one set. Gooby playing really well for Hinton. And Hinton is getting some good touches on defense, looking for them to turn those touches into quality offense here in set two. Because DNH, they bring the firepower in the front line.
There you see, a little bit lopsided as that final score was in favor of Dike-New Hartford winning all of those categories with the exception of blocks. We're ready for the second set here. First team to win 3 is your Class 2A state champion, Hinton. In the white uniforms, they're whistled for the 2 contacts. And you gotta be near perfect to win a state title. So looking to clean up some errors or miscues on your side of the net. Starts with playing clean volleyball. The issue is your opponent is doing everything they're about to make that hard. Good job disguising the tip. I thought she was gonna blast it down from the back row. Instead, she tips it over.
Running Booby out of the back row. A plan set, not just something that they're doing because they're out of system. I like that idea. Now Booby in the front row. So good job from Hinton on executing that.
DeRocher, the senior, was serving. The point goes to DNH, though.
Again, Hinton getting touches, touches on the ball in the right spot, but needing to control that from a defensive perspective to give themselves a chance to turn that into offense. So in the right spot, now control it.
Claire McCumber serving for DNH. Not the best serve reception by Hinton. And now DNH gets a good set, but denied. They run right into a brick wall as number 9 and 10 were there. That's Bailey Booby and Carlin Kovarna.
Solid block in the front row. Booby coming over to the outside, closing that block, moving well. She's quick, moving laterally from pin to pin there, able to close and seal for the Hinton block.
2-2 here in the second in the Class 2A championship match. Blocks adding up to points. They led Dike-New Hartford in that statistical category in the first set. They're leading them in that category here in the second.
This block is set up nicely, moving in. The set was tight, not a lot of space for Jaden to work with. But DNH responds well, running the slide behind to Bixby, who does a really good job of contacting high, making sure she stays up and over the blockers in front of her.
Jaden Peterson, the senior outside hitter with the serve. She's outstanding anywhere on the court, but she has 64 service aces on the year. 10 would be good. I don't know what category you have 64. Truly, she's worked on her craft. Down the line, and another kill. I feel like she's the type of player the student section needs a kilometer.
That would be fun.
Put a K up every time she gets a kill.
Fantastic idea.
She has 11, and we are just getting the second set underway. Well, Peterson might need a kilometer as well, as she now has 9.
sharp cross court. The set was inside, kind of a planned three ball. Moving her in allows her to hit right around that double block. Hinton needs to move that in, trying to take away that cross court.
Service ace, this time it is Bixby, Marin Bixby, the 6 foot middle hitter. 328 kills. She had 40 aces, ranking second on the team in that category, only trailing Jaden Peterson. Hint needed that one to stay close here as they trail just by one, get a side out, and moving out to the back row to serve.
Booby with a real quick tip, whipped it right around that block. Had she gone slower, slowed down her arm, I think that DNH block would have smothered it. So good job being fast, being quick.
Into the net, an attack air, and another point for Hinton. You talk about playing fast. That's kind of important because then the defense doesn't have time to get their block set up and to really get in a position to return the ball.
If you can keep the defense off guard, you can catch them on their heels, it's going to be a good opportunity to score a point, absolutely. Easier said than done sometimes.
Good attack out of Carlene Hicklin, the 5'9 senior outside hitter. Arguably the longest rally between these two teams, and it's DNH that gets the point and the side out. Dike-New Hartford won the first set and leads by one here in the second is number one. Serving, this is Lucy Varney, an upperclassman. Plays that setter position. Booby again.
Booby this time on the right side in the back row, that kind of one location. Swinging cross court around the block, catching that sideline, catching DNA off guard.
One armed up, laid out for that kind of Superman style. Setter dump, trying to catch him off guard. She dives underneath the net. There's nothing you can do in that situation. All your momentum's taking you to get to the ball. You gotta love the effort as a coach, but you can't go under the net, and it's more a safety thing than anything else.
Absolutely, scramble play here again. Good touch, back and forth, but without that control, you're right, it gets a little dicey when you're underneath that net.
Hinton swept Grundy Center in the semifinals 25-16, 25-21, and 25-18. They knew they had to, gonna have to dig deep against this Dike-New Hartford team here for this championship. Peterson, Jaden with the kill.
You see her really leaning into that cross court shot on the replay here. Good transition and approach. Just angles it, works it around that block. In between the seam, you saw it, in between the seam of those two defenders.
Blocked down for a point. Bixby and Peterson on that. And it's now DNH 10 and Hinton 8. Nice serve, but able to get a really good pass out of it are the Blackhawks. Peterson denied, and point Hinton. Well, this is similar to what we saw in the opening set, where it's real tight here in the first third. Now, what Hinton needs to do is continue to keep it tight or to start pulling away.
Hinton is doing well on their blocks. They're getting some stuffs and at least trying to get some block touches to help their backcourt defense. Sometimes, though, you just have to let points go, move behind, and this is one of them. A really great swing from Bixby around that block for that DNH point. But hopefully Hinton here can put that behind him, move on to the next point.
Been very impressed. We have not seen service errors in this two-way matchup. Both teams have been serving extremely aggressively, but they're getting them all in play.
Very good point. It's important to be aggressive, to try to get your opponent out of system, to try to slow down their offense, to hit your targets. Your coaches are giving you targets. But it's also really important just to keep it in bounds,
yep.
Right?
Yep. Another point as the block has been looking very strong. And you can read in the nonverbal communication, they believe they can win this. First set might have been an aberration, might have been an outlier. And they have the lead. It's their first to a dozen. Getting all fired up here. The crowd trying to will these young women to this second set victory. Really had to cover a lot of ground to get that attack off. Setter calls her own number. The slide. Look at that hustle. But unable to get it over in three. And the point to Dike-New Hartford.
Great effort on the Hinton side to chase that down, try to keep it alive. Dike-New Hartford, they're going to keep swinging at you. You bring it back over, they're going to pound it again, time after time. So good consistency from the DNH offense.
Relentless.
Yes.
The two Petersons have combined 16 kills. Bouvy, meanwhile, has 14 on her own. Still a lot of volleyball to be played here in this Class 2A championship match. In the net is called against Hinton. And then clarification. The Hinton crowd cheered. I think they thought that the call was going to be reversed. It was not. So the score is 13-12. Thought that one was gonna hit. Calm. Just misfiring on that cross-court attack. And DNH starting to get in the groove a little bit here. Both teams have two timeouts left, and there's a service error. It was close, but great heads up play in the back row. Said, I'm gonna step away and that one fly by me.
Good communication between the teammates telling each other, don't touch it, it is out of bounds. So great communication.
Down for the point, the antenna is waving. So Hinton scores the point.
Running that slide behind, normally automatic for Bixby. I think that set was just a little too far out, a little missed connection, either needing to speed up that approach to get a sooner contact or bring that set in a little bit.
Service air and side out. Into the front row comes Shannon Mormon for Dike-New Hartford. The serve is Bixby. The slide. 9 times out of 10, that's down for a kill, but not today. And then the defense continuing to be arguably their best offense.
The blocking for Hinton, they have started to figure out this DNH offense. You see number 12, they're shutting down the line. And again, pressing her arms back into the court so she doesn't get tooled.
How about a service ace? What a time to dial that up. No matter where she is on the court, she's gonna impact this championship match.
High level player in Bailey Bouvy. And right now for Hinton, blocking, serving, top notch. High level blocking and serving.
Not so fast as Peterson gets the side out there looking for. She's in double digits for kills.
When you need a response, DNH knows who to go to. They have options. That time it ended up being Peyton with the hammer cross court.
And again, these Peterson twins have been in this situation the last 4 years. Not only role players, but the go-to players. from a very young age.
They carry a lot of the offensive load, and they're both six rotation players, so they stay in the back row, serve aggressively. You mentioned Jaden is the Aces leader for the Wolverines, and then play defense. I think Peyton is the Dames leader, so it's not just their offense, it's solid defense as well.
Again, both coaches have those timeouts in their back pocket. Hinton making the run, trying to, for the second consecutive day, beat a team from Grundy County as they defeated Grundy Center yesterday. And Dike-New Hartford from Northeast Iowa gets that side out. Peterson here, Peyton puts the hand to it. In system is DNH, back row swing. That was wide open, and she knocks it down for the point to tie this up at 18-all here in the second set, Class 2A Championship. Shallow serve, near service ace, and now it's going to be an ace as they are unable to return it. One of the few things that you can independently do on your own in the sport of volleyball. You can't just set it to yourself. You can't just block it by yourself. Sometimes you can.
It's such a team sport, and serving, you're right. It's you and the ball and that end line, the contact point. But that's why volleyball is so fun. Everything is team oriented. You have to rely on each other. You have to trust each other. And throughout the season, those things improve, and you're hoping by the end of October, here at the very beginning of November for state volleyball, you're playing at your highest level, you're clicking on all cylinders, because you're right, it's the ultimate team sport.
20-19. Game hanging in the balance right here, right now. DNH would love to go up 2-0. Hinton trying to do everything in their power to make sure that doesn't happen. And the first timeout comes with the score of 21-19. Hinton is going to call the ladies over to talk strategy here, and let's listen in.
Full game. Okay, we're right there, but it's got to be now. Okay, we got to get a player right now. Okay, great pass. Let's put it away. What are we running? What do we got?
North.
Hey, are you pulled back right now? No, that was the last one. Okay.
So we got a 1-4.
Nine.
A clamp up the middle.
Yep.
I believe you start in the middle. Nine. Hey, we've done this all year. One service.
One pass. One pass. Okay, let's run a good play. Put it down. If you're running the back row, side to side. Okay? All right. Everything goes deep. Nothing short. Okay? So we can get to our spots and play defense from there. Push right here. This one.
Reminding the team that they've been in this situation before, reminding them that, hey, we just need to start with one quality serve, receive, pass, and then execute the offensive options that we have. I like her reminder, hey, for the back row attacks, let's go angles. Dike-New Hartford putting up a block usually on that back row attack right in the middle, so go pin to pin, side to side. Good pass.
The back row attack was blocked at the net. This one over the block. DNH with their back row swing, the roll shot just rolled off. And yeah, that is a point for Hinton, as four contacts would be the correct call charged against DNH.
Wolverine's back row attack didn't quite make it over, but I appreciate the teams, both teams still playing it out. Especially at state earlier in the week, when you have two courts going at the same time, there are whistles nonstop, the crowd is loud, and so, hey, if there's any doubt, just keep playing, right? They'll eventually stop you if it's supposed to be done, but just keep playing.
Hinton focused on small goals all season, taking it one game at a time, but the goal all season was to make it further than last year. They've done that already, as Dike-New Hartford beat Hinton in the semifinals last year. But right now it's 22-20 as you see the replay here. So many offensive threats. Bixby's a hard one to stop. And now Dike-New Hartford with the serve. It's another beautiful serve. And it's in! Holy smokes! That ball just dropped.
Getting out of system there, pulled off the net, a high ball to the outside. Ruby collects herself and puts forth a really smart shot. Cross court deep, when in doubt.
What can't she do?
It's a great question. Really solid state tournament and a good start to this match. A little bit of a trap set there. It was so tight to the net. Good job from the Wolverines pressing over to seal it. Even when it's tight like that, it's not a gimme. You still have to go up and block and stay clean.
Jaden Peterson with the block and using the second and final timeout now. Hinton, let's see what Coach Harms has to say for Dike-New Hartford.
So make sure we're following it so that if it's dropping, we get a chance to play it, okay? So make sure we're talking to our middles. Okay, if sometimes four is open, sometimes four is not open, so let her know. Okay, but make sure you're open so that if you're going, we're going. We're dropping our elbows when we're trying to go the rolls and stuff. Gotta keep our elbows up so we're rolling high over top. Don't drop and go into the net, okay? So good pass, let's go. Side out, let's stay in front. Let's stay in front, okay? Or the six, all right?
Coach Harms knows the sport of volleyball. She knows how to teach it from a young age. She has great assistants as well, right by her side. It is 23-21. Dike-New Hartford is scheduled tough, 49-0. And if they win today, they're in the discussion of being one of the most dominant teams in Iowa high school state volleyball history, because it's not too often you run the table. From starting on August 22nd.
And the different classes within those wins as well. They're not just all 2A wins.
Yeah.
From 1A to 5A, they're playing all sorts of opponents. And you're right, they're beating them, they're sweeping them.
Only one time did they not sweep their opponent this year. They won in four against 5A West Des Moines Dowling. So it's 23-22. Peterson flies in and knocks it down on the cross court kill. And that'll bring up set point for Dike-New Hartford as Shannon Mormon checks in. And Maren Bixby grabs that pink, black, and white volleyball to try and get that final set point here in the second set. Bouvie got it in, and it's now 24-23.
Reversing the flow there, Bouvie again, so smart as a hitter, coming in with that middle kind of two-ball approach, and then again, thumb down, back to that sideline. Really great shot.
Into the net, and that is how the second set ends. Bouvie has 17 kills, but a service error ends the second set with the final score of 25-23. Dike-New Hartford needs one more. Hinton trying to figure out a way to extend this championship match. We'll be back right after this timeout. You have it tuned in to the Iowa High School Volleyball Championships on Iowa PBS.
You're watching live coverage of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union Championships on Iowa PBS. Stay tuned, more to come.
Coming up on the next episode of Iowa Life, explore a public art display in Mason City.
Oh, cool, how cool is that?
Meet a world-renowned wood carver from Storm Lake.
All I'm thinking about is one feather at a time.
I love rock and roll.
And the sounds of Girls Rock Des Moines. That and more on the next Iowa Life.
Sunday morning at 10:30 on Iowa PBS.
From relationships between superpowers.
Hungry people are dangerous people.
To individuals just passing along an idea.
We were representing Iowa.
Iowans have been there to extend a hand in friendship or lift up people in need.
Dad just saw people hurting and he wanted to help.
These citizen diplomats took hold of a moment in time and built long-lasting relationships.
I would say I have moved the needle.
Monday at 8 p.m.
Native people are still here. We're not a stereotype. We're doing things to make a difference in this world.
Nobody's good at war. I have no choice but to fight for my country.
Could not imagine existence without the buffalo.
It's really great to work with oysters.
Here you go.
Whoa.
There's even more to love about Iowa PBS Online. Discover fascinating parts of our state when you follow Iowa PBS on Instagram. Connect with us on all of our social media platforms at iowapbs.org/social.
Hinton gave the Wolverines all they could handle in that second set. Much improved effort by the number two ranked Hinton Blackhawks, but Dike-New Hartford pulls away at the very end. Let's take a look at some of those highlights from that second set. Beth Booby is really taking this game over, but her team fundamentally sound defensively. I love the way Hinton plays defense.
Hinton with some top-notch blocks in that set, too. They had some aggressive serves as well that got D&H out of system. They got some aces in there. So Hinton throwing their best effort at the Wolverines so close in set two, wanting that to carry over here. New opportunity in set three.
Here's a look at the tails of the take through two sets. You can see eight more kills. Hitting percentage is something that I like to circle. It's how efficient are you with your attempts? But the stats don't lie with those blocks as well. That has been really challenging, and I'm assuming frustrating Dike-New Hartford's attackers. So here we go, third set. It's a must-win opportunity for Hinton, and it starts off with a D&H point.
Good defensive dig, miscommunication on that second ball. Two players going after it. Just an extra shout to your teammate, someone take control of it.
Dike-New Hartford continues to do so many things right. They get another point here to start off 2-0. Yesterday in the semifinals, they defeated number four Denver. Listen to these scores, 25-9, 25-21, and 25-12. It took just 59 minutes for that semifinal match, and that's just one of the indications how dominant this undefeated season has been for number one Dike-New Hartford.
We've talked about just how well-rounded their game is. Strong from the service line, balanced attack, good setting distribution, right? You gotta have a setter who can get that ball all the way around the court, front row, back row, and then just stifling defense, right? Just frustrating opponents because they don't let the ball drop and they just keep bringing it to you.
Hinton looking for a side out here. They go to Booby as she collects her 18th kill, and they get their first point of this set. Well, even after that semifinal win over number four Denver, they didn't really celebrate. They kind of have this workmanlike attitude, like, yes, that's great to get to the championship, but that's not our goal. Maybe we'll see them celebrate if they achieve their ultimate goal of winning the championship.
They are a very poised group, a very composed D&H squad. And you're right, they better celebrate with a state championship. But until then, all business, lots to take care of. They're having fun, though. Don't you worry. They're having fun.
Booby, fun fact, her uncle, Adam Booby, went to school with him, played baseball at the University of Northern Iowa, drafted by the Pittsburgh Pirates, made it all the way to AAA. And just seeing, folks, you have to understand she is a sophomore. I mean, I don't know where you put the ceiling on something like that with the fact that she has been so dominant, not only today, but the whole body of work of the season.
An important piece to this Hinton squad, just a sophomore. Excited to see what she can do in the upcoming years. A talented player, and it's not just because she's tall, it's not just because she's quick, but she has some volleyball IQ. We're seeing her swing from so many different positions, mixing up her shot, serving well, playing back row defense. So excited to see where she can continue to develop in this sport.
And on the other side, we need to talk about Peyton Peterson. She's enjoyed one of the most storied careers of any Iowa girl. The Louisville recruit has been a member of three volleyball and three state basketball all-tournament teams. She's been state tournament captain five total times, two in volleyball, three in basketball. I mean, she's the type of player that can go D1 in either sport. And she has a passion and love for the sport of volleyball. And a timeout on the court. 8-2. Dike-New Hartford leads. Let's go inside the Hinton huddle.
Hey, we have to talk, okay? We have to breathe. We have to play our game. All right, know your role. Know where we're at, okay? When you're on that court, know what your job is and take care of it, okay? That last attack, we have seen big time, okay? We need to move our right side in more, okay? We're gonna take that angle away completely, all the time, okay? Because everything is cut, cut, cut. So let's move that block in, okay? Make them go line, let's dig line. We're there on defense, but you gotta get there and you gotta get stopped, okay?
One point at a time.
One at a time, okay? Dig a pass, you can do this, let's go.
Well, it was their goal all season, one game at a time, and now you break it down to even more, 1 point at a time. You really don't want to dig a hole against Dike-New Hartford.
It's tough to come back. Right now, 6 point is the margin, and it's going to take a quality pass, running their offense 1 point at a time just to get back in this. But, hey, they're going to take that service error. They're going to run with it. And hopefully execute those blocking assignments that coach was talking about, because that was one of the highlights in set two, is Hinton putting up really solid blocks.
You're just joining us. This is the 2A championship. It's the final day of volleyball in the state of Iowa. It's hard to believe that the fall sports are wrapping up, and we'll be switching to the winter sports soon. Since that timeout, Hinton has and stringing some points together here. The number two team in the state of Iowa, co-head coaches are Robin Moore and Kate Ertegren. Robin, 22 years of coaching, Kate, 9. Slide. Blocked, but it's blocked out of bounds. Last touch by Hinton. And the Wolverines get the point, now leading by 5 on the side out. Bixby, one of the players that, with her size, she can do so much, but I've been very impressed with how she can serve and how she can do more than just put up a good block or slam the volleyball to the court. Another good serve, dropping to the knees to keep it alive. Booby, is it in? You bet it is. 10-5 now the score here in the third.
Paints that sideline, goes across, back across her body.
It's a game of inches, and that one was in by about a quarter of an inch.
A tough job these officials have with the speed that these players are swinging at. Great job to our line judges and the up and down officials, calling a really clean match so far. It's not easy, but they do a fantastic job.
Well, let's take this opportunity now to say thank you to anyone who's an official at any level, whether it's the Little League, whether it's AAU, whether it's varsity, whatever the sport. We need officials in order to have championships and seasons like this, and strongly encourage people to consider To me, it's a way to give back.
It's a fun way to stay connected to the sport, to be an expert, quote unquote, right, in a sport. It's needed. It's such a valuable piece. And so, yes, we say thank you to our volleyball officials, but then across the levels and the sports, thank you.
12-6 is number 12 sets it up. Now DNH with it. Real tight to the net there. Good job not going into the net, but another block scores another point. They're hanging right there, Hinton just down five. That lead's not growing.
Hinton with the solid block, staying home. It was an out-of-system high ball. They could have backed off. They saw that the tip, but staying home and pressing over allowed them to win the point on that.
Kovarna has been playing great, and how about that play by Carlene Hicklin, the senior? 137 kills in the regular season, a 328 average in the student sections, flexing as they can feel, okay, it's go time now, as they drop the first two sets to Dike-New Hartford. Beth West, Eric Braley on the call here for Iowa PBS. We started broadcasting at 10 a.m. and we still have the 1A championship match coming at you tonight in prime time, as we expect a good one from Ankeny Christian and Holy Trinity Catholic. Shallow serve. DNH, little give and go. Out of bounds on the attack.
Good idea trying to go line. We heard the Hinton head coach talk about take away that cross court shot. That leaves line open. Jaden saw it, tried to turn it line just a little wide.
Dike-New Hartford, one thing they love playing together, have that workmanship attitude. Peyton Peterson on the survey that we ask each team to fill out before the championships for Iowa PBS. Their team said she's known for keeping the team focused and being the serious one.
Every team has to have one, so kudos to Peyton for DNH keeping everyone on task.
Meanwhile, Hinton's team motto this year, we over me.
They have that on their warm-up shirts. Pretty fun design and a great motto. We over me to accomplish so much as a team this year.
Net violation against Hinton gives the ball back to DNH. Another interesting note on that Hinton survey, team superstitions. They love dancing to Cotton Eye Joe before every game. Now, Cotton Eye Joe, I had to look it up. 1994 is when that came out. I had the cassette tape of Jock Jams. It's timeless.
A little bit of a throwback, but timeless. Yes, it's a classic, Cotton Eye Joe. That's a fun one. That gets you moving. That gets you loose. You can laugh when you're dancing to Cotton Eye Joe.
You want to be loose. You don't want to be tight when you go out to go win a championship. 15-10, illegal attack, back row. Charged against Hinton as they have used one of their timeouts. Dike-New Hartford has both of theirs remaining. Setter dump, trying to catch the Blackhawks on their heels. So disciplined, both these teams. The block was there, but hitting it off the block, last touch by Kovarna. And it's a point for Dike-New Hartford. There's the second and final timeout for the Blackhawks, trailing by six, and we're gonna listen into Hinton's huddle.
Hey, passes look good, okay? Our passing is good. Out hitters, we gotta put it away. Cover, cover, cover our hitters, okay? Hitters, swing hard, swing hard. Don't go straight down the seam, side to side, use their block, okay? We can't go easy, we can't give them something easy. It's coming back too fast, okay? Serve hard, swing hard. We've got to push here, all right?
mean, this service team is trying to, you got a three, make a three, hit the four over the top, okay. Crush that line.
I'm going right. Yeah.
Got it. We haven't run that very much, yeah, okay? Yeah. So keep pushing that. Let's use that side of the court. Keep it on that side of the court. Here we go.
Family on three, one, two, three, damn it.
Let's go. Keep it up.
Coaching. Trying to talk strategy. It's a chess match, putting her team in a position to succeed. Well, Beth, let's revisit the keys you had for Dike-New Hartford coming in. Just looking at the scoreboard, I would assume that they're doing it what you expected them to do.
For DNH, we talked that we wanted to see them play scrappy defense, and they have. We said they've been relentless. It's frustrating to Hinton because Dike plays such quality, never let the ball drop defense. So that is going very well in Dike's favor. Then we talked about just continuing that momentum, and they've been able to do that, carrying it from set to set. And then even as Hinton inches back, especially in set two, and now keeping it close in set three, Dike-New Hartford staying composed, staying determined. They're really motivated to get that championship back.
Love the defense we're seeing on both sides of the net here. They just will not let the ball hit the court. Finally, they do. But ever since that second timeout, you can tell Hinton's dialed it up a couple notches.
Hinton earned that point. Good cross-court swing there. Got a touch, beaten in the back row, not able to control it to the setter. Good job from Hinton to get that point.
Little off-speed changeup, little roll shot. And now the push free ball over to Dike-New Hartford. Bixby winds up and knocks it through for the point. Well, looking at the crowd here from Dike-New Hartford, I mean, if you're planning your calendar well in advance, you can pretty much put this time of year, head to Iowa City, head to Coralville for the championships. Year after year, Dike-New Hartford is here.
You should at least block it off. That's right.
Now,
just in case. They're pretty consistent in their state qualifications. You've said the numbers, the number of years.
33 times.
Yep. Okay, I think you're right. Probably more than pencil it in. I think it'd be pretty safe to use a pen on that one.
17-13 serve coming here from Sailor Yower, a senior DS. Off the hands of the block for a point for Dike-New Hartford.
Bixby up and an option for her setter. Quick in the middle there, a good connection. Double block up for Hinton, so good job on that. But Bixby, she's a smart player and she uses those hands high. Tools it out of bounds there.
DNH with the point. We talked about Peyton Peterson and how she is going to play volleyball at Louisville. Bixby is heading to the University of Northern Iowa, and Jaden Peterson is also going to be a UNI Panther next year. So anytime you have three Division I recruits on one team, I think that's why you see the dominance that we're witnessing right now with an undefeated season.
Pretty fantastic to have one, maybe two, but three on the same team, all seniors as well. So experienced, just smart, high volleyball IQ. They've played a lot of high school volleyball. They play a lot of club volleyball. And they play a lot together too. So that connection, that chemistry that you need in the sport, they've developed it.
And Dike-New Hartford's motto, success is not given, it must be earned. They learned that last year as the number one team, losing in five sets to Western Christian. Locked down for the point. It falls on that line for the point. And now DNH can start to sense it as they have a 9-point lead, closing in on 25 here. Good pass, the set, Bixby. Gonna try it again, set her dump and smart heads up move. The corner was wide open as the Wolverines were packing the middle with their defense.
finding that location deep in the corner. Smart heads up play. I love the cheers afterwards. Still excitement here.
Dike-New Hartford won set one and two after that violation. Double contact. It'll bring up a 23-14 score with Bixby back to serve. She's hoping she can serve on out. Diane Harms, the head coach in her 30th year of coaching for Dike-New Hartford.
Booby with a good swing. This time running out of the middle, going to that sideline again. She is racking them up even in just three sets.
22 total kills. Peterson with 18. The other Peterson with 9. Tracking that one down, the overpass, and that's an easy one for DNH. Peyton Peterson, hammer time, and it's now match point here in Class 2A.
She made that look easy. That ball was so high. The timing of that is difficult, but Peyton Peterson hammers it away, like you said, made it look easy.
Match point through the block and down for the points. Hinton gets a much needed point there. And serving is Ashlyn Kavarna. Still facing match point. DNH on the serve receive. There's the pass. Nice set. Big swing, and Dike-New Hartford add another trophy to the trophy case. An undefeated season, another sweep, and arguably one of the most dominant teams in Iowa high school volleyball history. They are your Class 2A champions here in 2023. Hinton finishes the year 32-2.
A fantastic season for the Hinton Blackhawks. They fought hard. They brought so much effort into this state championship match. Congrats on a fantastic season to the Blackhawks.
Hinton won the War Eagle Conference. They won every tournament they were in. An outstanding senior class, but they return a lot as well. As you see the emotions of realizing their season ends for the second straight year, losing to Dike-New Hartford. Meanwhile, Dike-New Hartford, they didn't celebrate after winning that semifinal yesterday. I cut loose a little bit here.
Please direct your attention to the court for the awards presentation. Presenting awards are members of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union Board of Directors. Travis Fleschner, Russ Adams, Jennifer Donalds, Ron Fodness, and Zach Clark. And Representative Council Member Ken Slater. And now, fans, it's time for the Class 2A All-Tournament Team. From Dike-New Hartford, Marin Bixby. From Hinton, Ashlyn Corvana. From Grundy Center, Ellery Luring. From Grundy Center, Carly Willis. From Dike-New Hartford, Jaden Peterson. From Hinton, Bailey Boovie. And the captain of your Class 2A All-Tournament team, from Dike-New Hartford, Peyton Pearson.
Congratulations to the All-Tournament team. Big shout out to Ashton Kovarna, the setter, who just had a remarkable 32 assists and really ran that offense so well. Couple of Grundy center who finished in the semifinals yesterday having a spectacular year. And that is an outstanding group of individuals getting their picture taken right now.
So much talent in this all-tournament team. I would take that squad against quite a few teams. A good array of defense, offense. We got middles and outside setter. Fantastic. Nice job from that all-tournament team.
The Iowa Court Producer Award for the 2A Championship match. Presenting the award is Taylor Anderson of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union. This year's top producer of the 2A Championship match, from Hinton, Bailey Boovie.
Boovie with well-deserved honor. Boovie with 22 kills through three sets, winning the state volleyball top producer honor here for Class 2A. It's time to hand out the runner-up and state championship trophies.
Introducing your Class 2A runner-up, Hinton, and head coaches Robin Moore and Kate Ortegren. Dike-New Hartford, please complete the Class 2A bracket. Your 2023 Class 2A champions, Coach Diane Harms and the Wolverines from Dike-New Hartford.
A special senior class. They won basketball in 2021, 2022, and 2023. They went undefeated this year, no losses, and 108 of 109 sets, they were victorious. Final thoughts here of what we just witnessed here in the Class 2A championship, Beth.
A spectacular 2A final. Good fight from Hinton. We knew they weren't just going to back away based on their record and what they accomplished this year. Good job to Hinton. They have some quality players coming back, but wow, this DNH squad, 50-0 on the season. That doesn't come easily. A lot of hard work, a lot of perseverance. They were determined. A huge congrats to the Wolverines.
Team motto, success isn't given, it must be earned. They earned it. Your 2A champions, Dike-New Hartford, congratulations. And that means we only have one more championship to go as Ankeny Christian will take on Holy Trinity Catholic. We'll start that one at 7 o'clock here on Iowa PBS as we have the final match of a fun-filled day of Iowa High School Volleyball. Back with more after a short intermission from Extreme Arena in Coralville. This is Iowa High School Volleyball Championships on Iowa Public Television.
Funding provided by Musco Lighting, the sports lighting specialist, providing lighting systems for you, your project, and your community.
The Pella Rolscreen Foundation is a proud supporter of Iowa PBS. Pella Windows and Doors strives to better our communities and build a better tomorrow.
And by Fareway Meat and Grocery, For more than 80 years, Fareway has been proud to be an active part of the communities we serve. Learn more at fareway.com.
With our Iowa roots and Midwestern values, Farmers Mutual Hale is committed to offering innovative farm insurance for America's farmers, just as we have for six generations. Farmers Mutual Hale, America's crop insurance company.